Oh, hey everybody, snuck up on me. Just checking out this sweet cutlass right here. And today we're at St. Paul, Minnesota at the fairgrounds. The Street Machine Nationals is going on, 3-day event. So we're gonna be looking at a lot of sweet rides. Gonna try to do some interviews, talk to some people, and you know, maybe grab some food, who knows, whatever. But hope you enjoy the video and like, subscribe, share, all that fun stuff. And yeah, thanks for watching. So how long did you say you had this?
A little over 8 years.
8 years. You've done all the work to it?
Yeah, I outsourced the shortening of the rear axle, and then there was some other welding that was done on the frame that I didn't have a power enough welder for.
Okay.
But other than that, I did everything else, all the paint body work, welding new quarters on it. It's actually a 72 front end with a 71 grill, but the car's a 73. So everything from here forward was cut off and welded on. Wow. All new sheet metal. So
wow. And how long did it take you from beginning to end?
So it was 2.5 years from when I pulled the motor and then ripped everything apart during COVID, and then it's got 1,100 miles on it.
Wow.
So we just got back. My wife and I went on a trip to north of Lutzen.
Okay.
So we put 600 miles on it after only having 400 miles on it.
And no problems.
I wouldn't go that far.
little things here and there.
Yeah,
huh?
little nuances, but awesome. For the most part, yeah, it was good. So.
So what do you got going on for the motor here? Tell me about that a little bit.
So it started out as a 318. It's now a 392 stroker. So it's a full forged internals. So it's an Ego crank and rods. Racetech is who we hired to make the custom pistons for it. And then the cylinder heads are a set of aluminum cylinder heads that we had ported by Knowlton Thunderhead. So okay. He has a CNC program. And then it's a Sniper EFI system with their HyperSpark. So the computer controls all the timing, and then obviously all the fuel. And then CVF out of New Prague is who made all the brackets and everything like that for the accessory drive kit for the Serpentine.
Yeah, that's beautiful in the front there.
Yeah, so it we on the dyno, we went through and it made 475 right at redline, and then it makes, I want to say it was like 460 on torque, but that's at like 3,200.
Okay.
So it's mini tubbed with a leaf spring relocation kit. So we got a 305 tire in the back, and yeah, it's still, unfortunately, it's way more than the tires can handle.
Yeah.
There's no
yeah.
trash control, no nothing
right.
like that. So,
yeah.
But
cool.
So yeah, it's getting there.
Awesome. that's gonna be a wrap for this video, everybody. Thanks for watching. And looks like the rain is starting to roll in here, so everybody's taking off. You see all the cars behind me here. So we're gonna call it a day. Thanks for watching.